It's a jumping rabbit that transforms into a fish. And the fish transforms into a bird. And the bird transforms into another fish. And the fish is a flicker. And it's also a magic flap. And that makes 5 models in one. And now I'm gonna teach you how to fold it. Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this model, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of Kami, but you could use a sheet of printer paper cut square. Begin white side up and fold diagonally in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Unfold and fold in half in this direction. Unfold and fold this edge to the crease, but we're not going to fold all the way. Just fold from the corner to the crease. And unfold and repeat. And now pinch the corner so that it sticks up like that. So that's a rabbit ear, but don't flatten the rabbit ear yet. And repeat all of that on this side. Okay, so pinch both of them and now bring these two flaps together. And flatten. And now fold this edge to the middle. And repeat. Fold in half. Like this. Fold this flap over this edge, all layers. Unfold, turn over, and do the same thing. Unfold. And unfold. And now we're going to bring this flap down, wrapping it over these two edges. And flatten like this. And bring it back like it was, turn over, and now we're going to bring this flap down, folding on the existing creases, and flatten like this. And bring it back, and go to this side, and go back like that. And just exercise in both directions. Make sure that it works in both directions. So this here is the simplified magic flap, and this is how it works. What you do is you hold like this, and you just move your hands like this, moving it back and forth so that the flaps take turns. Like that. If you hold in the middle like this, you can just use your other hand to hold the edges and it goes back and forth like this. Now notice how it doesn't look that convincing because these flaps aren't quite going to the very top. So what you can do is you can just flatten it like this and fold it in half again like this and again like that. Just keep on flattening it, folding it back and forth so that that middle crease gets loose. And now try it. Yeah, that's better. All right, so that's the magic flap. You can play with that. All right, now I'm going to show you how to make the fish. So what you're going to do is, on the side with the two flaps, fold in half so that the flaps are visible. And now open here and fold this flap up like this. And then fold on the crease like that and squash. So it's like that. And repeat. So open, fold up, fold on the crease, and squash. Now we're going to open the pocket, holding like this, and squash it so that it looks like a fin. And repeat. So open and squash like that. And now for the tail, fold up. Well, it's not really that important how big the tail is, but in order to get a good bird head, it's good if we have a big tail. So do I have a guideline for that? Yeah, that's a good guideline. Okay, so make a pinch there. Okay, if you want another guideline, once you fold that half point, you can fold like this, and then fold up, and now you have that crease, and now you have a full guideline that you can fold on. Like that. And now make a reverse fold, bringing this back down to taste, or so that they look kind of equal. And there's a nice fish. And we can add an eye to it by folding up. Maybe on the point, that's good. And then fold down. And that could be an eye. Or if you fold like that, then you can open that little pocket and squash it so that you have a little eye. And repeat on the other side. Like that. Now for this part, open up one of these two white pockets, either side, and just reverse fold. Like that. And we have a nice fish. All right, to turn the fish into a rabbit, all we have to do is... Let's sink this a little bit more. Okay. All we have to do is unfold this. Unfold these ears just like that. And fold this down on this point so that this point would align with this edge if it were extended. So like that. And now unfold and reverse fold. So open up the middle and fold it inside like that. And now here's a tricky little move. We're going to separate the flaps like this and just take these two flaps and bring them to the side. So it's like that. Okay, and now fold this flap like this. We're folding so that the edge touches this point and these edges align. And insert into this pocket. And repeat. All right, I just figured out how to do the ears. Just open them up like this. And just like that. And there's the rabbit. And if you open up a little bit like this, then it can stand like that, and it can hop. Just hit right on the back here, and it jumps. Like that. I found that the more it's flat, the higher it will jump. But the more it's flat, the harder it will be to stand. So you just want to find that happy balance where it balances and it jumps. Like that. All right, to turn it into a bird, undo these folds, undo the reverse folds, and now just slide this down like this. And slide down. So these are the legs, and now open here and bring it to this position. And there's a bird like that. So that's an okay bird, but if you want, you can fold it back and then forwards to make it a little bit bigger of a head. So something like that, and then make a little beak with a little pleat like that. And you can shape the legs with the little squashes from the fish. And there's the bird. And the bird goes like this. It's pecking the ground. Doing its gymnastics. All right. Ooh, there's another fish. You can go like this. And go like this, and like that, and like that. There's another fish. And this one is a flicker. Oh yeah. All right, so in review, let's try to get all of the shapes. So let's first go for the bird. So we go like this. All right, so from here you just reverse like that and then fold forwards and turn to the side. And there's the bird. And now let's go to the fish. So we go like this.
Fold the model in half.
All right, so we're like this and we make a reverse fold like that. And then another reverse fold there. And these come in like that, fold up, and do the same thing on the other side. And push this into the pocket. And there's the fish. And to go to the rabbit, the ears change like this. And we unfold here, and we reverse fold on this crease, and switch them like this, and then just valley fold into the pocket. And repeat. And There's the rabbit. And if you want it to be 3D, you can just put your finger in there and just pinch like that and press down so that it makes a nice round back to it. And it might still jump a little bit. No. Yeah, it no longer jumps, but if you flatten it, then it jumps good. Or here's another method of rounding I just discovered. You just push this in like it's a volcano, and then from underneath, pinch it. And that way, the flap doesn't stick out. All right, hope you guys like this little model. Or if you fold it really big, I guess it could be a rabbit hat. Or you can put your finger in here, and it's a rabbit finger puppet. And I'll see you later.